Okay, so in the first class of the Prolog programming, we have discussed about how to install GNU Prolog compiler. So I hope you have already installed the Prolog compiler. So that I have already installed. Now, today we are going to talk about how to write a very simple program in Prolog and how to execute that. So here, this is the way you need to write down a Prolog program. So you need to first open the notepad. After the notepad, you need to write down your program over here, that like I have already written. So you need to save it. So you need to go to the file and then save as. Then I'll be saving this program as prog1.pl. This is the way you have to save it. So extension would be .pl, and I am saving it in the desktop. So I have saved it, right? So if you just saved it, it will be saved. And here in the desktop, you can check over here, this particular program has been saved. That is prog1. Then the same symbol is there. So that is the PL extension has been taken by the GNU Prolog. So now let's come to the program. Here in the program, we are going to know about the AND and OR functions of the Prolog, how to write that. Here, suppose we have some people naming as Seema, Ryan, Brittany, Danny and Joe. Now there are some names, and the names, some names like each other, and some names, there is a liking between some names. So here, that is the like Seema, Ryan means Seema likes Ryan. Now like Ryan, Brittany means Ryan likes Brittany. Like Brittany, Ryan's means Brittany likes Ryan. And Danny Joe's means Danny likes Joe's. And just check, after the end of each of the sentence, there is a dot is there. That is, the full stop is there to indicate whether this particular line has been written completely or not. So this is how the logic have been written. Now, these are the some statements that I have written. We need to go for the rules. To rules, the rule is that whenever meeting between two arbitrary person X and Y will be possible when X likes Y and Y likes X. So that comma statement and symbol is being represented. That is, X likes Y as well as Y likes X. And this is the way rules have been formulated. That is, meeting between these two person is possible when there is a liking between both the way. And the friendship is possible when there is a one-way like. So this is the OR representation by the semicolon. And after each of the line, full stop has been given. And by colon and dash, the rule have been represented. That is, friendship is possible between X and Y when either X likes Y or Y likes X. So meeting is only when there is a two-way liking, and friendship is possible there only there is a one-way liking. Now these are the rules. Now we need to execute the rules. So I have already saved the program in the file save as, and then the name .pl. Now that has been saved in my desktop, this particular file. So I'll be opening that particular file. So now just check, it has been already given, that is, the compiling has been done. Just check, the compiling of this particular file has been done. That is the same, that is in the desktop, prog, that is prog1.pl, that is has been done. Now we need to check whether the code is being running properly. We need to give some query. So the first query is, suppose we need to check whether meeting between Seema and Ryan are possible or not. So I am just copying it, otherwise you can also write it down over here. Whatever you want to do, you can write it. I am just copy and paste it for simplification. Otherwise, you can type it. Just type it and just check always the name, spelling and everything has okay or not. Otherwise, if Seema's spelling is S-I-M-A, then that will be taken as another person, right? So just check the same is there or not. And after the query, there will be a full stop to indicate the query has been written completely. Now what I need to do, I need to press a enter. So I have pressed the enter and the answer is no. So why no? just check that Seema likes Ryan, but Ryan likes Seema. That statement is not given ever here. So there is a two-way liking is not there. So meeting will be no. Now just check another query, that is between Brittany and Ryan. So I am just copying it and I will be pasting it. Otherwise you can write it down over here in the console as well. So I have given it. Now I have pressed the enter and the result is yes. Why yes? That is just check Ryan likes Brittany as well as Brittany likes Ryan. That is a two-way liking is there. So meeting will be possible. Now let's come to the friendship query. There are two queries that they are between Danny and Jones. So if there is a one-way liking is there between Danny and Jones, then result will be yes. So I am moving to the console. I am pasting it. Now just check it. The answer is true. Why the answer is true? That is Danny likes Jones. So answer will be true. Right? Now let me just move to another thing, that is another query, that is between friendship Ryan and Brittany. So that time over here, okay, so why this is the thing over here? So it was a true then question mark, that whether I want to know whether it's a true or not. It's so I have given over here interest, so means it's checking whether it's a true or not, and it's a true. So answer was yes. Now I have given the fourth query and the last query for this particular program and pressing the enter. So again there's a true question mark, that is whether the compiler need to check whether it's a true or not. So compiler need to check that it's a true or. So the answer is yes. Why the answer is yes? As Brian likes Brittany. One way liking is there, so obviously friendship will be possible. So this is way. And whenever you are going to get this, that is question mark dash, then this cursor will be blinking. Then this blinking means only when you need to write down your query over here. So the cursor is blinking means you need to write down your query, whatever be your query it is, and give to press enter. Then your result will be displayed whether it's a true query or the answer of the query is true or false. This is the way this program one is going to be executed. This is the first program of the prologue. From the next class onwards, we'll be talk about much more advanced version of the programming. So this is much for today, and thank you everyone for watching this video, and happy studying.